Hello there, everyone. I hope you're all doing well. Today, I thought I'd take you along with me while I made a protective spell candle for my home. I've been wanting to get into making candles from scratch a little bit more, so this will be one of the first times I'm doing it. I am not a master at this, but I want to learn how to do it more and better, so just getting that out of the way. I also want to say, while I will be making a candle from scratch here, you are welcome to use a candle you already own or a already pre-made candle, and you can make this work that way as well. I'll get into that in the recap. And also, for any of you who don't wish to follow along in this vlog, the recap will have all of the information on how to do it and all that good stuff, well, at the end, and all of the timestamps will be down below. For those of you here for the vlog portion, let's figure this out together, shall we? So to make this candle, I've selected two herbs. I want to start with rosemary, a protective herb I've been using a lot lately, along with sage. This is just common garden kitchen sage, and it still holds many of the same properties while also being more accessible and appropriate for use by everyone. I've chosen the rosemary here to help kind of purify and protect, and then this similar. So those are my two main go-tos, and I will be putting in fragrance that is the same as well. And for today, I am using soy wax to make a soy wax candle. So first things first, I have to create a double boiler situation to melt down the wax. This is just warm water already, and I will be adding in the measured out wax into a separate container to, well, double boil it. So I've already pre-measured out my wax and fragrance and all of those things. It will be different for everybody, I believe, depending on what you're using. So I won't give out those instructions exactly. Pretty simple. I just want to make one candle for this, so I have about one candle's worth of wax. I'm just going to add it into here and then get it, well, melting down. And while this water is getting up and this gets melted down and up to temperature, I'll work on prepping the rest of the candle and kind of talking through my thoughts on this. So in my practice, I tend to use candles a lot as a background part of spell work. They aren't often the main portion, but I've been wanting to branch out a little more and use them more often in my day-to-day stuff. So I figured making my own would be a good way to go about this. And I'm not exactly prepared to stick this wick down properly, but I figured this will either be a very big mistake or it'll work out, so I'm just using masking tape and hoping for the best, as you probably know by those of you who've been here for a while. I enjoy being really heavily involved in the whole process of my practice, and anywhere that I can start from the ground up and work is my preferred way of working, and so I figured this was just the natural next step. Plus, it's a good way to add herbalism and or herbal magic and share magic with others in a way that is like a good, nice gift, and it's one that will keep a little longer than most of the things I make. So I also want to work with that, and that's pretty center. Not perfect, but good enough.
It's hard to see with all the steam, but it's melting down very nicely. So right now, if you can hear me over the noise of it bubbling, I need to get it up to 185 in temperature before I can add in the fragrance. That way it will absorb the best and smell the best and do all of those good things. So it's just a bit of a waiting game. Alrighty, so now that it's off the heat and at a good temperature, it's time to add in the scent and then stir for about 2 minutes. Then I am going to allow it to come down in temperature for a bit and add it into the jars. But while I'm stirring in the fragrance, it's a very important time to work in intent and what I wish for the spell. Now, just to wait a little bit until it cools down enough to be dressed. Looking pretty perfect to me. Now, just to let it cure. Alrighty, hello there, you guys. Welcome to the recap. Oh. Yes? We have a Sasquatch now. Is this your Sasquatch? This recap is going to be a little bit different from the vlog portion of the video because in the vlog portion, I made a candle from scratch. Here, I am not necessarily going to teach how to make a candle from scratch, rather just how to make a candle into a spell candle like this because I am not practiced enough at making candles to really teach that, but that's something that I'm working on learning more about so that hopefully I can one day. So just some clarification there. This is not exactly how to make a candle from scratch, especially because everyone's going to use different things and make them in a different way. So I want to leave it open for everybody to do that. There are plenty of tutorials all over YouTube and the internet on how to make candles from scratch if that is something you are ultimately interested in. Personally, I tend to use candles more in a surrounding part of my craft. Very rarely are they the main thing or a large component in the spell, unless I'm doing something that is a long-term spell. Mainly because I think it's good practice to use spells or candles and spells just once. Thus, it's much easier to use them in spells that are of longer duration. And since most of the spells I craft on the daily tend to be really simple one-off kind of things, I just don't use them that often. But they are something I feel drawn to every now and again, and recently I have been. Though backtracking to really only liking using them once in a spell or one candle per spell, if you're doing a shorter term spell and you only burn through part of the candle, feel free to save that and melt it down and make it into another candle for later. Just cleanse it and really make it, give it a new purpose. But anyways, back to this specific candle. For this candle, I wanted to focus on making a home protection one. One that I could burn a couple times a day, maybe in the morning or the night, just to add a bit more protection to my home and something I could keep on my altar or at my workspaces to burn while I'm crafting. And well, as you saw if you watched the vlog, I made it from scratch. And that's really just because I tend to like to be as involved as I possibly can in my practice. But like I said, you don't have to have them from scratch to do this. So to make this home protection candle, you'll need a jar candle, pre-made or made by yourself. And I would really recommend it being a jar candle, and I'll get into that in a moment. And then either the oil version or the dried version of these herbs. I'd recommend using rosemary, garden sage or kitchen sage, and cinnamon. Personally, I used both the oil or fragrance of these herbs along with the dried versions of these herbs. If I'm in a pinch, I only tend to use the dried version of these herbs, and I really personally always include those in these kinds of candles, and that's why it's important for it to be a jar candle, because they do add a bit more fire risk to it. But when it is burning in a jar, it really is still very safe. Because even if they do catch fire, if they're small enough pieces, which they are in here, then it isn't a big deal. It won't spread and it will stay within the jar. But as always with candles, it's really important to keep your eyes on them and just stay around them and don't leave the room with them on fire. Now, if you already have a pre-made candle, you can still add the oils to the candle once it starts burning down, and this will just help add fragrance to it, and I think it's really helpful to do that. It's a good way to add intention, or you can just go with the herbs. Like I said, either or works.
So to make this candle, gather your supplies. Once the top layer of the candle has burned down, sprinkle in your herbs or oil or both. Though if you're making the candle from scratch, I would recommend adding the fragrance or oils while you are making the or melting down the wax. But whatever is working best for your situation. And while you're adding the herbs or oils or fragrance, spend a moment with each one to infuse your intent and what you wish for this spell. I worked this in while I was stirring in the fragrance in the beginning initial stages of crafting the candle, and I also did this while adding the herbs on top. This is a crucial step because it really sets what this candle is going to be about. I have a whole video on intent explaining all the different ways you can infuse it into spells and just figure out which way works best for each individual practitioner, and I will link that down below. Then simply allow it to set and then light it. I would recommend each morning or night, or you can shift it, whatever really feels right, and if there is any other times during the day that you feel it's necessary to have a little bit of protection. I've been lighting it in the morning and at night, spending a few minutes infusing my intent into it and just kind of meditating with it. I've been keeping it at my altar, and I burn it while I'm working or meditating or just practicing in general. I've been really happy with it, and while I still have a bit of a ways to go in learning how to craft candles from scratch, I feel like I'm getting there. I didn't have all the perfect ingredients this time, but that's okay. It's a learning curve. And like I said, I only really use them when I'm doing long-term spell work, and this is a long-term spell. So feel free to mix this up as you need, or do it for different purposes or with different herbs, whatever you have on hand that works for you. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. It's been a rainy couple of days here, and this was just a nice rainy day craft for me, and it will be a wonderful spell to just have going in my daily rituals. And with that, I guess let's do the outro, shall we? If you haven't seen it yet, I'd really recommend checking out my other channel. I share vlogs and just kind of more of my passion for filmmaking. I spend a lot of time and care making those videos. They mean a lot to me, and I would love it if you checked it out. And it also has a lot more of my daily magic and other things there. And I know it's not for everyone, but if you can and wish to, I'd really appreciate it if you checked out my Patreon. There I share herbalism, art, and some other fun things, and it's really what keeps things going over here. So I really appreciate you all there. I couldn't be doing this without you, and it just means a lot. So thank you. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a lovely day, and I'll see you soon.